Robert Power keeps the yellow jersey as race leader. Day 2 at the Giro della Valle d'Aosta sees the success of the Belgian Laurens De Ploeg, who defeated at the sprint the leader of the GC after 153 kilometers, really incredible. Ready, steady, go. Soon a breakaway by four riders which seems to be set to an end. In the second chasing group, the American TJ Eisenhardt of BNC team and Nicola Bagioli of DALF. The escape ends almost in the final kilometers of the stage, as well as the second chasing group. Bagioli, DALF, wears the first mountain classification jersey. Davide Ballerini, Unieuro, does the same with the sprint catch one. Many surprises though today at the Morillon Les Deserts. Diego Pablo Sevilla of Fundación Alberto Contador, who was into the second chasing group composed by 12 riders, reached the first group, being for a while the leader with a minute ahead. Bagioli and Salvador, riding together, forced the pace along the last descent and got first, but the fantastic action made by Australian team at 60 kilometers to go had a positive finale. Robert Power and a fragmented group chased the leaders along the last descents toward Morillon Les Deserts, and the Belgian mocked the yellow jersey. So we are with the winner of the first stage of the 52nd edition of Giro della Val d'Aosta. Laurens, how was the race today?
It was a really hard race from in the beginning. Then there was a breakaway of 16 guys and I thought, yeah, they go for victory and we just go for a Gucci C. But then in the end we came very close to the leader of the race and in the end I won the sprint and I'm very happy.
You raced really to the end of the finish line.
Yeah, we caught the leader of the race in the last 100 meters, so perfect.
So what's next?
I don't know, I hope to do a Gucci C, but I think Roberto is a big he's the best now for the moment, he's outstanding for the general classification, so yeah, we'll see.
So compliment.
Thank you.
So second day as a leader of a GC, how do you feel?
Yeah, it feels good. I mean, the team worked so hard today, so it was really good to have a crack in the finish there. And my teammates really did this for me today, so I can't thank them enough. And Jack Haig was riding super strong, and he just sacrificed himself on the last climb. And yeah, he was riding super strong, so can't thank my teammates enough.
Did you expect to keep your yellow jersey?
When the gap was 8 minutes, I didn't think so. I thought it was over for sure. But obviously with so much climbing, it's so hard if you're out the front. So,
an obvious question. Do you think you will keep this yellow jersey till the end?
It's a long way to go, eh? It's a lot of days to come, and it's definitely going to be a tough few days. So.